Meridian. Hi guys, and welcome to part one of my Star Wars Knights of the Republic 2, a continuation from one. I am playing on my TV freaking V because my monitor decided to go out on me. So it's a smaller freaking monitor screen, and I had to fit a lot of stuff in, find out that this works, and window mode, because it wouldn't capture, OBS won't capture this game in full screen for some reason. If I just want to go in full screen while it's recording in the background, it don't want to do that. So window mode, I can actually get the gameplay, and you can actually see the mouse, because when I had it in full screen, it wouldn't show you me doing this. The only thing you can see were like the movies. You couldn't see the gameplay at all. He's be standing still looking like an idiot, just like, oh, what's going on? And then like when if I go into my game, you only see like a very freeze picture right there. And it's like the character's moving around, but the whole picture's not moving. So I had to play this in window mode. So we're gonna start a new game. I think I changed my mind. I'm gonna play light side for this. This is blonde, kind of. I only played the small part of the beginning of this game, and I never ever beaten this game. It's probably because when I got this game when I was younger, we had this game when we were younger. We only kind of like beat one and then two, about to start two, but guess what? The disc broke, or somebody else broke. Somebody did something to the disc and we couldn't play the game. It was always that one level, the first beginner tutorial board as your character, and it's gone. Now I'm trying to figure out my class again. I was gonna go Sentinel because it's a mixture of well balanced. But what was I? Was I a Sentinel? Or was I a counselor? I think I was a counselor. But I mostly fought with her lightsaber. Didn't use my powers, even though I love pain. It says Jedi Knights are masters of the Force and spend less time on combat training. Then are well balanced and possesses many skills. I was gonna pick this one. We're gonna do a custom-made character, and let's pick our portrait. Okay. Well, I like my girl here, but look, as you can see, compared to like the first game, they changed her style, and it's this weird ponytail thing in the back. And I don't like the way her face looks after 10. I wanted to go her, but I don't like clone rules really well on game characters. Unless it looks really cool. And I think that's the best doll of African American girls. So I have to pick between them. With her red looking eyes. Oh, again, it's gonna be hard to choose. I mean, we're probably gonna be in mass or whatever anyway. Should we pick her? Should we pick my girl here? Ugh, so hard to pick. You know what? Since we were kind of had her face model in one, we can go with her in this one. She's Exile. And let's see, attributes. Thank you very much. I know I'm gonna put a lot in. I think wisdom. So let's put everything in 10. Except for intelligence, I'm leaving that alone. So everything's gonna be 10 right now. I'll leave in strength as it is. I'm going probably 13 or 14, but hold on. High conservative for implants. Oh yes, that's a big yes, yes. Oh, wisdom too. I'm bringing it up. You go up, and I'll put one more on that. And there's our build attributes. But I knew wisdom and that would have been up because we need those implants. So, our skills for that matter. Okay, I know I'm gonna. One of my friends said that persuade, anyway, put like a lot of persuade, because he says crucial in the game for, I think, my class, I think. So, I'm gonna put one in domination. What could I not say it? I'm gonna put some security. Oh. It says get out of there. Sway. Security. I need persuade to be more, so. Treat injury. Be there. Security. Computer use. Well, while we level up, I can. Because I know I want to put one in this. Well, we probably go to level. Whatever level that makes me change, I probably put one in that. Boom. Let's recommend in. So you want more in stuff as death? Excuse you. Wondering. Wonder. Sway. Then treat injury. Okay, we can add that in later. I'm a lad. Damn, the music laughs. Hold on. Yeah, well, I turned it down on math thing. Oh, Jedi Sense. Oh, yes, there we go. So we're gonna pick one of these. And I think I'm gonna put in conditioning. Where is it? Yeah. So also in terms of reflecting the character's physical condition. But do we want it in something else? Because we already got all these unlocked already. Toughness. Or do I need toughness? I know I was always too sword. Don't want to use my two weapons. But let's put it in toughness. Kind of probably will need that. So the name. I don't know the name. Should I just memorize it? Like, because I don't know what to call her. She's Exile. That's complicated. I can't say it, but let's keep the. Let's put Suri in there. And then last name. Hello. There we go. That's good. Let's play. Let's enter into our life of the Exile. Light side playthrough. Let's hit it up. Damn. Oh no. Gotta be uncomfortable for a while playing this let's play since I'm on the computer.
Multiple hull breaches detected. Proximity alert. The Ebon Hawk is adrift in space after a terrible battle. Most of its crew are dead or dying. You lie in the medical room in critical condition. You won't survive long without medical attention. The hyperdrive is damaged. Main power must be restored in order to bring the engines online and dock with the nearby Paragus mining station for much-needed repairs. Your fate, and that of the Ebon Hawk, depend upon T3M4, a lone astromech droid. Return to this location at any time to skip the prologue.
We're going to continue with...
Press WASD to move T3M4, and turn. Press caps lock to toggle first person free look. Hold control to look about. This is the galaxy map. It shows you are near Paragus, a mining colony. When the hyperdrive is fixed, you can use the galaxy map to choose a destination planet.
So you can't do anything, you gotta go check.
You have new quests. To view your quests, open the game menu, default, escape, and look.
Yo, but love it. Hey, I am the freaking boy. I'm all drunk like on the controls.
This is the main hold. You can hear a banging noise coming from the other side of the door to the storage compartment, but the door is sealed shut and cannot be opened from the outside.
I can't do nothing for you.
I gotta search this for more stuff.
Your security skill is too low to open this.
Yeah, beat his ass. Beat it up. Beat it up. Yeah.
It's humping it, alright. Say, so get it, get it.
Sometimes bashing or blowing open a container will break some of the items in the container, but you can use even broken items. They can be turned into useful components at a workbench.
Excuse me. Thank you.
blast door is magnetically sealed and cannot be opened.
Yeah, you wonder what the hell happened here.
This is the cargo hold.
What's up, lady?
This container is locked and requires a key. Search the ship to find the key to this locker. If you encounter a difficult lock on a container or door, you can use a security tunneler on it to improve your chance of opening. The lock on this metal box is... will make for excellent target practice. Use the weapon from this container to attack the droids.
Oh, that's so bad.
You can equip a weapon.
Okay, boy, we gotta equip a weapon on you, boy.
Change your target by pressing Q or E, or left click on the object you want to target. To attack an enemy, left click on the sword icon or press 1. To attack actions, left click multiple times. Good work defeating the sensor droids. To continue combat training, open the metal box again, and more sensor droids will appear. This is the main hold. This old woman appears to be dead. There is a key card on the body that looks like it opens a locker somewhere.
Yes, it's the locker that you were telling me about. Yes, we know. We know this. Let's go in.
This is the cargo hold.
It's a new lady. A new lady.
Use the keycard you found to open the locker. The impact armor from this locker can be equipped on the equip screen. To open the equip screen, click on the blaster icon in the top right area of the screen. Or press U. This is the main hold. This blast door is magnetically sealed and cannot be opened.
Jack, why? I'm drunk. Can't drive the droid away.
This lift will take you to the outer hull of the Ebon Hawk, where you will find many parts and mines to use for accessing and repairing the hyperdrive. Use the lift controls to go up. You are in critical condition. You will need a med pack to be stabilized. You have found med packs. You can use one to stabilize the condition of the human lying on the bed.
So it seems like the sexier ones got through, but not the other ones I picked.
The med pack can stabilize your condition. Success! You are stabilized. To recover fully, you will require the medical facilities at the Paragus mining station. But you are not in any danger of dying from your wounds right now.
Get it. Let's go. gotta help him out more. Before we get out of here.
There is a hull breach in the area beyond this door. Safety protocols prevent you from opening it manually. Try using the security computer in the main.
Oh yeah, I did close that.
This is the end. This door is damaged and cannot be opened with your security skill or by bashing it. You will have to find and use an explosive trap to open this door. Take the lift outside the Ebon Hawk to find one.
So we're gonna teach you everything right here and now. It's a hell of a word.
This is the cargo hold. Talking to other characters is much like using the computer console in the cockpit. Scroll through your response options or move the mouse cursor, and then click to select a response. Note that some responses may influence how other characters react to you, so choose carefully. Furthermore, certain skills, powers, and attributes may modify what choices you have, or how successful you are with those choices. 3CFD is malfunctioning. You can fix him by using a part. Luckily, you have already found one. If you repair 3CFD, he can join your party and assist you in repairing the ship.
Okay.
Success!
Do it,
you have fixed 3CFD. Now he will join your party.
Come, buddy. I don't know if you're thinking me or not, but yeah.
Is 3CFD is now a member of your party. To change which party member you control, click on the portrait or press tab. Later, when you have more companions, you can add and remove. This is the main hold. Beyond this door, you will have to use solo mode, default V. Click the solo mode button at the bottom right area of the screen. While in solo mode, move 3CFD to the security computer to open the door for you.
No way. No. Over there. Over there.
This is a workbench. With a workbench, you can break down objects in your inventory into components. You can then use the components to create repair kits, weapons, armor, and upgrades. Because of the damage to the Ebon Hawk, this workbench has limited functionality. You can still use it to create a repair kit, which you can use to repair yourself. Use the workbench to break down the items you've found into components. Then use the components to create a repair kit. These sparking wires connect to the trigger mechanism for the inner and outer garage doors. You can open and close the doors from here. You can't open the outer. Do you want to? Door closed. Do you want to do any?
This blue. Wow, we're being the saddest freaking ship.
The store is sealed shut, but the magnetic clamps are not engaged. You may be able to override the door's locking mechanism from outside the ship. This is the starboard dormitory. This blast door is magnetically sealed. This is the garage. The sparking...
Get your bed in. Yes, come to put it. Okay, time to go outside, kiddo.
This is the utility. You can use this lift to take you to the outside of the Ebon Hawk.
Good sit. Ooh, that's like so pretty. Wow. That's a scary, but it's very pretty. Dang. It's been tearing our shit up. Look at that. How those workers fixed it in time? How long were we asleep?
This is the starboard side of the Ebon Hawk. This busted engine port has some needed parts for the Ebon Hawk's hyperdrive. Take the parts here back down below to get main power restored. This busted engine port has some needed parts for the Ebon Hawk's hyperdrive. Take the parts here. This open hatch has some parts that will be useful for getting main power restored.
Okay, now she shut it up. Let's get it. Okay, we need those mines to get into that rooms.
Don't forget to explore. This is the port side of the Ebon. The bubbles ahead indicate mines that you've detected automatically with your awareness skill. Some mines require higher awareness to detect. Approach mines carefully. They will blow up and damage you if you get too close. You can use your demolition skill to either disable or recover these mines. Recovering mines requires a higher demolition skill than disabling them, but you get to keep the mine, which you can then use to set as a trap for enemies or break down into components at a workbench.
Yes, and you say we need one for them. Good job, I just killed this one too.
You can use the explosive device in this missile to blow open the engine room door inside the Ebon Hawk. This will give you access to the hyperdrive. After you plant a mine, back away quickly so that you do not take damage.
Thank you, robot. What else before we get back? Let's see what it is.
This is one of the Ebon Hawk's quad laser turrets. They are damaged, but you can scavenge some parts from it to use in repairing the Ebon Hawk.
Yes, I'm drunk driving, my boy, so calm.
You can use this lift to take you back
inside. Yes, go back inside. I mean, it's still so beautiful there. No matter how scary it looks, it's still beautiful. Yes, we got another room we need to blow up. Where are you?
This is the main hole.
Yes, I am. Oops, I think I went in circles with Buddy Boy. Nah, I think I blow up the door now.
This is the engine room.
Open sesame. Come on, buddy boy.
This is the engine room. The port engine is shut down, but appears intact. Fixing the hyperdrive will allow you to restore power to the port engine and bring primary power online. The hyperdrive is suffering badly. You won't be able to make the jump to light speed until it is fully repaired, and you do not have the needed equipment here on the Ebon Hawk. However, you should be able to rig the hyperdrive to restore primary power and bring the port engine online. This will allow you to dock with the Paragus mining station for full repairs. Success! The hyperdrive is online. Primary power is restored. Only one step remains. Return to the galaxy map in the cockpit and travel to Paragus. The starboard engine is badly damaged. Fixing it won't be possible until after docking with the Paragus. The port engine is powered up. You can now use the galaxy map to travel to the Paragus mining. This is the main hold.
Can we open this door now?
You can hear a banging noise coming from the other side of the door to the storage compartment, but the door is sealed shut and cannot be opened from the outside.
What the hell is that noise?
This is the cockpit.
The cockpit.
You can now plot a course to the Paragus mining station. To dock with Paragus, left click on the Paragus planet to select it, and then left click on the travel button. Sensors show the door to the storage compartment is being sliced. There is someone, or something, else alive on the Ebon Hawk.
He's okay. That must have been a scary issue for those things. They say, hey, what's up?